Greetings, everybody, and welcome back to Minecraft Let's Play with Snipeskilla here. Better watch out. I'm gonna shoot you. I'm gonna shoot you with my bow. What the? Where did that go? Oh, there it is. So, guys, last episode, I promised a tutorial of a slime farm. And yes, we will be doing that today. So that's the one thing we're going to be doing today. I'm going to show you how to build a slime farm. I have an area marked out over there, but first off, I got a comment, and I'm like, woohoo, comment. But yes, the comment was to fix these lights and make them down one more block, just because they might look better. So we'll work on that real quick here. Get that one. I wasn't experiencing this much lag when I was just previewing. I probably adjusted one of my settings though, which was probably why I wasn't. So, I apologize for the lag. I still have a terrible computer. Alright, so let's reform these blocks. Get the trapdoors back on my hotbar. Oh, come on. Come on. You're gonna lag out on me just switching blocks. Light there. Light there. And yeah, I think these might actually look better two high instead of three high. So I'd like to thank the person I'd rather not name for the comment. Thank you very much. And anything to help with these builds is very, very much appreciated. And thanks for taking the time out to watch my videos. And that, there we go, and last one right here, and there we go. Alright guys, so yeah, I'm gonna say that actually does look better. I might need to cap off the top with another trapdoor. I'm pretty sure I don't have any wood on me though. Let's take a quick run up here to my chest. I believe the next episode we need to really work on this situation over here. We need a better, way better area for storing things. I meant to say, man, I cannot talk. Like, you take 2 days off of YouTube and you can't talk. Can I not place? No, I cannot. Okay, so I can't cap it off with that. Maybe. I think I'll. Never mind, I'll fool around with it a little bit later. But I have something else to show you guys that you guys might be interested in seeing. And it would be very much appreciated if you could give some feedback on it. I need these. Look at this. We have a new addition to the design of our cave here. We actually have a nice hallway here. And wait, oh, it features nature too. Look at this waterfall. I still need to do a bit more to it, but look at that. Look at that waterfall, guys. I got a little access area up to here that I need to cover up. There's still quite a bit of places in this man cave, I guess we're still calling it, that I still need to do. Like, I still need to do up this area here. I still have this dispenser here for my cows. I should probably take a few of them out for some leather. And if you'll let me turn around, I have this little area. So I believe down here is where we should put our storage room. So I'll probably spend a little bit of time today or tomorrow digging this out and probably show you guys pretty much the design I'm going to come up with when I get the time to build that. But, as promised, let's get to the slime farm. Alright guys, welcome back. So, no more than 20 blocks further is our slime chunk. So, if you guys do not know, and I hope you do know by now, because you're all probably extremely experienced Minecraft players, slime chunks are 16 blocks by 16 blocks. I thought I heard you coming up on me. Oh, wow, he got worried up there. And there we go. So yes, slime chunks are 16 by 16, which is a standard chunk size, and I believe slimes only spawn at level 40 and below. So right now we're standing on the surface. I think I will probably mine down to level 40, and then we'll clear out the 16 by 16 area. But for this slime farm that I'm going to be doing, which I might need to build in creative to show you guys what it looks like, or find a picture online, either one. But yeah, we need to dig out 2 blocks further than the actual size of the slime chunk. So I think I'll get right to it and get down here to level 40, which actually is not that much further below the surface. So 40, I believe, is where our head is. So if we go 2 blocks out, just dig a bit here. Little area established. I didn't bring any ladders on me. That was real smart of me. So yes, we got 40, and then we go 2 more this way. And might as well, just because of having a better look, we'll take out the corners. So instead, I believe we end up with a 20 by 20 square instead. Or is, no, it's 18 by 18. Pardon my calculation. I passed math, don't worry. But yes, we need a 18 by 18 square. I should probably mark off the corners. Right there. Yep, okay, so right there is the corner. And now we want to go 16 this way. 13, 14, 15, and 16. So this will be our next corner right here. We'll just dig out a little bit more here to give us some room. I should probably grab torches. This is really dark for you guys, as I can see on my little recording software. So give me 1 second. I'll head right back up to the surface, get some torches, and we will be all nice and well for this. So I will be right back. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, after a little bit of preparing, I believe I am ready to go. I got a few enchanted pickaxes here, an enchanted shovel, and I kinda didn't show you guys what this hallway mostly looked like when we actually first saw it, so just give you guys a good look here. I still need to fill in the plants. I think my one goal here is to get every single type of plant in here just to have some variation in the plant looks. Like right here, we only have a dandelion and a birch sapling. So yeah, it's kind of not incomplete. Kind of not complete. We do have the waterfall here, which is, I believe, it's a nice addition. It's some naturey kind of stuff in here. I'd like to have some waterfalls and water pathways and such in here instead of just like all this stone and stone brick and wood look, because we need some kind of nature in here. We can't just have wood and other things, I guess I would say. We can't just have that. We actually need some nature. But yes, guys, after preparing a little bit for this, we are heading back up to our slime farm here. I think 56 torches will do us nice and fine. Oh, it's raining now. Oh, come on. Why has it got to be raining? Ugh, it's raining on a parade. Well, actually, at least the sun's coming up, so that's a bonus. Two thumbs up, sun. Alright, so let's get back down here. Okay, guys, we are back down in our slime farm here, and I figured I might as well do a time lapse for this, because I really like time lapses. So what I'm gonna do is, I do have to work today, so this video might be up Tuesday. I might have to record more tomorrow, which is Tuesday. As you may have figured, it is actually Monday when I'm recording this, but I might need to record more Tuesday, just so that I can get all of this done and we can actually move on to the building part of the farm. So I guess I will queue up the time lapse. So guys, enjoy, sit back, and watch the fun begin.
Thank you.
guys, what time lapse wouldn't be a time lapse without explosions? Which means we have to go back up there. Dang it! Oh, this is the most tedious task ever. You know, I have no problem digging giant holes to show you guys how things are done. But when it comes to having to jump up a hole and then run back and forth and the rain, it sucks and it's annoying and it's really bad for recording. But yes, let's get some explosions going, because explosions are the best. And we have quite a bit of TNT that I'd like to go through. So, cue the explosions. Okay guys, so I set off one explosion. I was figuring it would chain react, but it didn't. So let's set off another one. And let's get away. These things really don't like exploding each other. Alright, here's the other one. Yeah, explosions. There is one here. Run away. Alright, so this is definitely going to make our job a lot easier. And it's actually going to take out some of the roof too. Which I actually do want some of the roof taken out. But yes, without further ado, let's get back to more explosions. Okay, so learning from our last mistake, I've spaced them a little closer together, and we are down to our last piece of TNT as we set off these final three here. And of course, they didn't explode each other, so they might actually need to be a lot closer than I expected. Or... oh yeah, I know what I'm doing wrong. I don't have any airspace between so that they can expand, because as you guys know, fire likes to expand itself. 1, 2, there we go. Yep, see, that was the entire problem right there. I didn't have enough airspace in between them, which caused the faulty explosions, I guess you would call them. Where is my corner? Wow, it's just buried in gravel. Just absolutely buried. But yes, so I guess that's enough explosions for now. Let's get back to the time lapse. Dum dum dum. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, look at this. Level 1 is complete. Which is nice and dandy. Now what I'm doing here is I don't want any torches on the ground because I am actually going to be digging the ground. So in order to provide light up here, we're going to have torches on these little cobblestone lanterns, I guess you would call them. We will keep the corner pieces though, because we do need to know where exactly our corners are. That is the one thing of importance that we're going to keep on the floor. Alright, so guys, let me explain exactly how the slime farm is going to work, since we've already dug out quite a bit of area and wasted a lot of pickaxe durability doing it. So, where to begin? Where to begin? Since update 1.8, slimes actually will follow iron golems, and this is a slime farm to maximize efficiency and get a lot of slime balls. So the thing we're going to do is we're going to have 6 or 7 layers. Each are going to be about 3.5 blocks tall, and they're going to be nice and lit by some pumpkins. In the like roof ceiling kind of thing where it's like the half slabs and such, because mobs do actually spawn on top half slabs instead of bottom ones because they aren't actually counted as full blocks. So in each, like every 2 layers, we're gonna have iron golems on the sides to attract the slimes towards them, and this 2 block gap is actually going to be their dropping. It might actually need to be 3, I don't know. We'll probably keep it at 2 for now. And then once they fall down, they'll most likely fall into a water stream and be carried into one corner, like pulled up with the water, because they actually swim in water. They'll be pulled up, they will drown, they will die, and then hoppers down below will collect the slime balls and deposit them in a chest. So that is how we're going to be implementing this slime farm. It'd be better if I could show you, but I do not have a copy or template or anything of it. I'm actually just building it mostly off by memory and what I can remember for it. So, I really don't... Oh, come on, block lag, don't do this. Kinda at a loss for words of what to say right now. How's it going? Yeah, we're doing good. I'm mining some stone and gonna be building a farm for you guys. I don't know what to talk about in these videos. Maybe future projects, because why not? Because we're digging up some stone to talk about some future projects. So the thinking base is going to be coming underway. If you guys do not remember what the thinking base is, it is going to be pretty much like a base that has a mind of its own in vanilla Minecraft. So I don't know why I'm not digging 2 layers at once. I should be doing that instead. So let's do that. Alright, so the thinking base is going to be a base that controls everything pretty much in our base. So it'll probably control our... we'll be controlling farms. It will have, hopefully, a personality, so we can feed it, we can, I don't know, pet it with a button or something. That's gotta be a painful petting. Petting with a stone button. So yeah, it'll have, like, human characteristics, it'll hopefully play pranks on us, like, it'll shut off the lights, or the lights will start flickering and mobs will spawn in our place and we have to punch a button to get it to shut off and stop being a little trickster. We're gonna have like a giant glass jar for it because it's essentially going to be a brain in a jar. And I said essentially, it's essentially, there we go. Words are coming to my mouth now. So essentially it'll be like a giant brain in a glass jar and we will be able to give it personality through redstone. It will operate on a daylight sensor, which I have no idea how to make. Yeah, I have absolutely no idea how to make a daylight sensor. So that's going to be another learning thing. And I don't know how they actually operate, so yes. But I think, oh, another cool idea would be have like a brain stem kind of thing. This may sound kind of creepy and like, what is this guy talking about? But maybe we could do like a kind of brain stem kind of thing that kind of like branches out and attaches itself onto the walls or something, you know? Like, this is, I think this is getting a little too freaky for us, so we'll probably just stick with a brain in a jar for now. On other notes, guys, I am actually pricing out a computer right now. When I get the money for it, and when I actually can order in parts for it and the case and all that, so that is definitely something to look forward to. Because that will get rid of this. Look at this. This might be a little confusing for you guys. Warning. Look at this jumpiness. Like, you can see the little short pauses when I do that. So I'll stop doing that just to save you guys the headache of watching me twist the camera really fast. So I am pricing out a new computer. Probably put some system specs down below of what it might be. I still have yet to figure out what kind of graphics card I'm going to be getting and if I'm going to be using the power supply from this computer that I currently have, which is, it's a beautiful power supply. Nice and black, and the theme I'm kind of sticking with for the new one is black and red, so it's gonna pretty much everything be black and red. So yes. Again, I have no idea what kind of graphics card I'm going to get. A friend recommended a GTX 780 or something like that. I'm not entirely sure. I'll have to do some a lot more research actually on it. But I do have the idea of what motherboard I'm getting, the case, which is actually a nice black and red case. Probably gonna need cooling and all that, and oh man. You know, it's a large project to take on when trying to build your own PC. I didn't think it was actually going to be this long and difficult of a task. So, yes, anyway, guys, getting back into more Minecraft news, we do have modern Minecraft now. If you guys have not watched, I'll probably leave a link in the description to Minecraft Infinity, which is our first ever, well, second ever modded series kind of let's play, but I don't think I would consider Regrowth as more of a let's play. Because, like, this is a. Minecraft is like my series kind of thing. Like, each channel has a main series. Minecraft is most likely going to be, for now, my main series because it's what my computer can run the best. We will be doing other games other than Minecraft because, you know, Minecraft kind of gets boring after a while and you start running out of ideas for what to do, and, you know, I'm already starting to run out of ideas. Like, this slime farm is actually something we need for a project that I have in mind, a very slight project. It actually has to do with our base. But man, this is starting to look like my spider farm. Except for all the stinking gravel. Ugh, freaking hate gravel so much. But yeah, I think this might be the amount of hole I dig for today. I'll probably come back tomorrow to this. I should probably grab some ladders too. Get a nice ladder kind of thing going here. But yeah, guys, we are underway. So I'll probably have to come up with a block scheme. Not sure what we should stick with. I don't think I really want to stick with the wood theme of our base. I think I want to go more of like hardened clay, and I could probably do some quartz. That's another thing we have to do is we have to check out the Nether a lot. But yes, next episode is most likely going to be storage. This episode's probably going to be a really long one because I still have to dig out quite a bit of this, but this is actually all for today. So I'm going to head up back to the surface, get some ladders, put the ladders down here, and I will rejoin you tomorrow. So Yeah, I guess that's where I kind of end it at night with no rain. Thank you. Thank you, great gods of the sky, for not bringing rain upon us. But yes, guys, I will see you tomorrow. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. So, guys, I am just doing a little bit of behind the scenes work here, but I'd like to just give you guys an update. It is currently Tuesday when I am recording this, and man, I am starting to feel real sick. Like, my throat hurts and all that, and I'm just not feeling the greatest. So leave a like, comment. It'll make me feel a little bit better to see you guys supporting me in this little difficulty time with just the sickness, I guess I would say. But guys, I did a little calculation here for how many blocks exactly we have to mine out. So not including this layer, we have an 18 by 18 area, and it's about 324 blocks per layer, and iron only does 250. And we need to do, how many layers is it? 35 more layers, because we are on level 35 right now. So we need to do about 35 more layers. So we're gonna be going through a lot of pickaxes, and I do not have the TNT to actually mine this out. So that really is just, it sucks a lot. Like, so much. I can give you the grand total, actually. That'll just show you the magnitude of blocks we need to mine out. So I calculated at 324 blocks per layer, we need to mine out exactly 11,340 blocks. Yeah, I have nothing to say. I have nothing to say at all. That is just an insane amount. And diamond only actually does like 1,500. Wow, we're gonna need a lot of pickaxes. This is gonna actually take longer than I expected. So, yeah. This might end up being like a two-part series, or episode even. So, I'm just gonna get back to digging here, and maybe I'll cut to a comment of the day, just so that we have a comment, and in the next episode, hopefully, I have quite a bit of this dug out. So, I will see you guys in just a moment. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back, and it is time to end off the part one episode of our slime farm tutorial here. So, I actually have two comments today, as you might notice in my little hotbar. And I sort of threw down a piece of coal because I wanted to take my armor off. Might as well just put it back on, pick up that coal. Because the coal is useful. So, let's get into the comments today, guys. So, comment one. Hey, Snipes Killer. Mate, make those lights too high. I think they'll look a lot better. Mind keys. Thank you very much, Mind Keys. I took your advice, like I said I would. I actually do think the lights look a lot better too high. Those lights will be eventually covered up with the birch staircase things that I put around the edge, which I still haven't gotten to. I'm actually currently in the works of digging our giant slime farm hole. And no, I'm not gonna cheat on doing it, guys. I'm not gonna use any TNT. I am gonna dig it out all by pickaxe, and I'm gonna have to find some more diamonds, because, like I said, pickaxe diamonds only do about 1,561, so yeah, that's not even close to enough to what we need. But yes, again, thank you very much, Mind Keys. They actually do look a lot better. They actually do look a lot better. Alright, so guys, comment number two is actually a question that I found online. Hey Snipes Killer, my question today is, are you afraid of heights? Keep up with the great videos, or keep it up with the great videos. So by random questions and Snipes Killer. I'm not really afraid of heights per se. I think it's more of the argument that I'm afraid to fall off a building. Like, if I was standing at the top of a building, I think I'd be more afraid of, like, leaning over the edge and falling than actually being on the building. It's always like that controversial argument, like, am I gonna fall? Am I afraid of like being on top? Like, it's a really good question. It's hard to answer. But I do believe that I'm not really that afraid of them. So yeah, another thing I would like to do before we end it off here, guys, is that I'd like to know what you guys think about this hallway here that I added in. Do we need more nature? Do we need to break it up a bit more? Because I feel like we're missing something. Like, it seems a little too plain. I know we're missing flowers and such, but like, we do have the waterfall, and I'd like to add some more nature in. So if you guys have any ideas about what I should do with this hallway, whether I should take off the fences and make like a curved roof, whether I should add in, like, I don't know, some trees and plants and something around here, like tear out a wall and just create like a giant nature farm or something, let me know what you guys think about this. I am always up to take in comments and answer them accordingly, I guess. No inappropriate comments, please and thank you. But yeah, guys, I think that's pretty much it for part one of our slime farm. So I'd like to thank you guys for watching. This has been Snipeskilla. Leave a like, comment, subscribe for more amazing videos, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye bye! Come and get it.